Okay, so I am going to move on to the next. I will come back for questions. So, the first question is, why do we have to do all this commit business? Why can it not be automatic? So, as I said at the beginning, HE is only a tool. It provides you certain functionality. It is up to you to use the tool effectively or not. So, it is up to you to make sensible commits. And the reason you make commits is there are several reasons. So, every time you make a commit, that state of the entire repository is saved. So, I can go back to that point. So, every time you think that this state is worthwhile remembering, you commit it, or it is an important change, you commit that change. Okay. Now, you may say, array, what is all this? I have to unnecessarily add a file, I have to commit a file. But remember, it is only two commands. You add, you commit. Okay. Now, the advantages to this is, it makes it very easy to go back in time. So, it is just a little bit of discipline and it is not a lot of work. And once you start getting used to it, it will become automatic. So, do not think too much about it being a pain, oh, I have to keep doing this commit business. It is not at all that difficult. And soon you will see the benefits of why you need this. Now, supposing you have a set of files, I will skip this slide, I will come back to this in the next slide. First thing is, I now make a change. Everything is fine. Now, let me change . Okay, I have just added one more line, change the previous line. Now, if I do status, what should I get? I should get modified. Only test.sh is modified, obviously. I didn't touch hello.sh. I now want to see what has changed, right? I can do hg diff. This gives me what is called a diff of the text file. It is telling me that the file called test.sh is modified. The original time was this, the new modified time is this. These are what are called context lines. It tells me in which location these changes are there, and it actually shows me this line is gone and these two new lines have been added. Am I making sense? So, the diff actually tells you what is the changes to what lines, and it is very clear to see this. Okay. Now, I can choose to commit this, or if I do not want it, I can go back and say hg revert test.sh. Now, what does it do? It has created a new file called hg test.sh.orig, of which it does not know anything about, which is your newly modified file. So, what did I do? I did hg revert test.sh, and then I did hg status. It is now saying test.sh is the same thing. So, let us see. So, this is the original version that I had added, but test.sh.orig is an untracked file that contains my new modifications. So, if I do not care about it, I can simply say rm test.sh.orig. Okay. So, basically the diff command shows me all the changes since the last commit. Okay. Revert will undo all changes you have made to all files compared to the last commit. It will restore your files back to the original state at the last commit. So, if you say, array, I was just playing around with these files, I want to forget about it, just do revert. If you do revert minus minus all, it will revert all changes that you made. If you give it specific file names, those file names alone will be reverted, and for every file that was changed, it will save the equivalent file name dot orig also. So that in case you want to unrevert your revert, you go back and read the orig files and copy paste it back. Is this fine? Okay. Now we have done all this commit business. What is the use if I can't go back in time? So the first thing that you can do is, I want to now see what is the difference between revision 1 and revision 2. So if I do hg log, there is revision 1 which was adding test.sh, revision 2 which is better hello message, right? I now want to see the difference between version 2 and version 1. To do that, I do hg so I can say minus r 1. So I typically diff will always tell you what is the difference from the current version to a previous version that I specify. So if I just do hg diff now, what will it give me without any arguments? The difference between the current and the latest is nothing. So it will give me empty. Is this clear? But if I say no, give me the revision difference between 1 and current, it tells me I have made this change. Hello world, I made h capital and added a full stop. Is this clear? Now supposing I want to see the difference between some two specific versions, I can say minus r 2 minus r 1. So as an example, I will create another version. Okay. Hg status modified, hg commit. Hg status, hg log. Now I have four versions. I have the original version. I have version 1 when I added test.sh. I have version 2 with a better hello message. And I have version 3 with new edit to hello.sh, correct? I have four versions. I want to now say, give me the difference between current version and original version. So I can say hg diff minus r 0 hello.sh. Give me the difference for this file. So it says that from 0 to now, these are all the changes. I have added have a nice day and cleaned up the error message and removed one new line between this line and this. All these changes it records. Now I say I don't want till version 0, I want till the penultimate version, which is I think 2. Notice that it only shows me the difference between that version and the latest. But now if I want to say no, give me the difference between 2 and 0, that also it will take. So basically it is easy for me to figure out what changed in every file or a specific file. So I can also do it for all the files. If I don't specify any file, it will list for me every file. So the first listing here is hello, the second listing here is sh, test.sh. So I will repeat this. The whole point of doing commits is that every commit is saved. The entire repository state is known at that point of time. So if I want to see the differences, I know I can use hg diff. But if I specify a specific version number, that version number can be passed as an argument. And then if I do hg diff minus r1 minus r2, it will tell me the difference between 1 and 2. There is another way by which this can be specified, which is hg log minus r number colon another number. So, you can use that syntax as well. Okay. So, now you can start to see the advantages of using version control. So, what I will do now is, I will illustrate to you a bunch of additional features from the command line itself. Okay. So, let me add some junk.sh. Or why do that? I have these two files, status is clean. Supposing I want to display just the last log message, I can say hg log minus L1, it will only show my last log message. If I want to say, give me the last 2 minus L2 will give me 3 and 2. Okay. So, now this is the state of my repository. Now, let us say I remove the file. If I do hg status now, it should tell me something is wrong, right? It is basically telling me this file is missing. So, if you go back to the status line, this file is missing. How do I get back that file? It's gone. Fortunately, we have version control. I can say hg revert it's back. I changed the file, I removed it. So I'm saying revert. And the status is restored. It still says now everything is fine. Is this clear? So, I can basically get back a file if I deleted it. How do I say move this file? So, let us find out. I do hg help pipe to less. I can use rename. I think there is an alias for it to mv. So, hg help rename. Notice that the alias for rename is mv, which means instead of rename I can say mv also. Am I making sense? So, now I do not want to call test.sh test.sh. I want to move it to, what should I call it? Any suggestions from the audience? New test.sh. Okay. So, I want to call this hg rename, or I will say hg mv, I am lazy, test.sh to, what is the destination? Okay. Hg status, what is it saying? It is saying test.sh has been removed and new test.sh has been added. It does that automatically. Now, if I want to save this snapshot, what should I do? Commit. So, I do hg commit. So, now we have change set number 4. which renames test.sh to new test.sh. Is this clear? So now if I want to see the difference, everything is logged. If I want to go back, there's another command which I will come to in a short while, which will let you update your entire repository to that version. I can see all the files at that point of time. So now let's see, status everything is fine. I now want to create another file and I want to remove it. Say I don't like this test.sh. New test I don't want, it's waste. I want to throw it away. So I want to say hg rm now it is removed. It simply says new test has been removed. Now again, what should I do to make this, to fix this? Commit. So now I have my entire project history up to this point of time. Now how do I go back if I want to now get what are the versions we have? I have 4, 5, 4, 3. Let's say I want to go back to version 2. So there's this command called hg update. Let's look at its help. So the aliases for update are hg up up checkout or co. What this does is it allows you to update the repository's working directory to the specified change set. Okay, so it's important that there's little more to this than just a revision number. There are things called branches in Mercurial which we have not yet covered, so we'll look at that later. However, right now I want to go back to say version 2. How do I do that? I want to know, I may have hundreds of files, but I want to get the status. I want to see all the files at that point in time. So if I do hg update, if I just do update, it will say nothing, because by default it will assume you want to update to the latest version. But if I say hg update, I have to specify a particular chain set. So I take this, I copy that. You don't need this, you just need 2. Hg update 2. Remember, at the current version, there's only one file. I remove new test, I remove test, all of them are, there should only be hello. But now what is there? Let's see. Two files are there. And remember, the current version of hello.sh has hello world and something, have a good day or something like that, second line. That's gone. Now if I want to go back, I can do hg update. Now do you see the power of committing? So every time I make a commit, I can go back to that point in time. So if I say, oh, at this time the project was working, I made some mistake today, 10 days ago I know it was working. I want to rebuild my entire source, run it. I can rebuild it, run it, figure out, then I can say, oh, that time I made these 10 changes. Look at the diff between that version and the current version and say, oh, this mistake I made here. Fix that mistake and now you can figure out. So the nice thing is, because you snapshot it in time, I can go back in time and revert from my mistakes, not using the revert command, but I can figure out what mistakes were there and then fix those mistakes upstream. So I am able to go back at any point, look at all of the files. So unlike in RCS, there is no notion of the entire repository. Okay? So there's two terminologies that I have not quite elaborated in on. This directory that I have here, this my project directory, is called a working directory. The repository information itself is inside the .hg directory. The thing about modern distributed version control systems is your working directory itself contains the entire repository. Unlike in the past when the repository was somewhere else and your working directory was local, right now everything is in one place, which is extremely convenient. As you can see, just open a directory, put files in it, and you can start version controlling that entire directory. You can also make directories. For example, I can say mkdir okay. Now hg status, it says I don't know anything about test/test.sh. I can say hg add test/test.sh, same thing that you did. Hg status will say it's been added. Hg check-in, CI is a alias for commit. So here I have done, I have committed it on the command line. I didn't have to open an editor because it's just a single line. So I say hg commit minus m, give it a string in quotes. Now I have this. And notice I have the directory. So if I do hg update 2, the directory is gone. Hg update, directory is brought back. So the nice thing is I can go back and forth. It makes sure that all of the stuff that you have added is taken care of. So if you have not added files, hg cannot help you. So this is the reason it's important that you learn to make this a habit. You add the files that are of relevance, you commit them, and every time you think there's an important change, you make the commit. So remember, supposing you have a version control system, you made lots of changes. You changed over the last month, you've been making changes regularly to all your files, but you didn't commit them. Then no one can help you. Hg will not be able to help you. So it's important that whenever you make a change that is significant, that you make a commit with a suitable commit message. Only then can hg help you. If not, it can only help you till the last time you commit. So commit early, commit often. Okay? So I think now you have enough idea of how to create a repository. How do you do that? Hg init, hg status will tell you current status of the repository, hg log with an optional minus say L number of log messages you want. So minus L say 1, hg add, right, file name. Hg add, I'll put them in comments so you can see them. Hg commit with an optional minus m. Right? And then again hg status. then HG diff with an optional minus R version number colon some other version number, or minus R 1 minus R 2, something like that. What else did we learn? HG update, very important. No, HG revert, before that revert. Then we looked at HG update, okay. Update without any arguments will get you to the current state, the latest version, or you can say either minus R revision or just give it a revision number. It will update to that revision number, and the revision number is the first part before the colon. Then what else? HG MV slash rename some file, HG move some file to some other place, okay. Then we had HG RM file name. So the one issue that I have not discussed with some of you asking me as a question is HG revert is not working. First thing is, when you say HG revert is not working, generally it's a good idea to give an error message. So let me do something, let me recreate the problem. HG diff is saying I change the dot to an exclamation mark, right? Now I want to do HG revert. It will give me an error. HG revert has to be explicitly told minus minus all if you want to revert all files, or explicitly specify as individual file. The reason is, if you accidentally hit HG revert, finished, all your changes will be gone. So they make it safe for you to do. If you do HG revert, it's sorry, you didn't specify any files. So you do HG revert hello.sh, then it will work. Okay, the next question is how to check specific log info about changes. I don't know. I think you know enough shell scripting that you can figure out how to do that. Use grep. So HG log and grep for that substring if you are interested in something. Usually many of these version control tools, there are tools to do the visualization with a UI. Okay, there are plenty of tools. I don't know if this has been installed. Unfortunately, it is not installed on this. So there is something called HG view. It needs to be installed. So if you notice, there is this package called HG view. Is this on the internet? So what did I do? I wanted to use HG view. There is this package called HG view, which will give you a view command that you can run from HG, and it will present a UI. I simply did apt get installed HG view. For those of you who are not able to follow what I did, I will just put it on a comment so you can see it. Now if I do HG view, HG view, it will show me all of the So this is now the original version. This is the change log. My screen is a little small. So adding out first files. So it's just added. These are the files that have been added. The second commit has adding test.sh. The third one says, look at the diff. It's showing me clearly these red lines were removed. The green line was added. Fourth commit shows me this. And remember, if you have changed multiple files, it will show you all of those multiple files. Then this one simply was a rename. New test was created. This removed new test. This added a test directory. So all of this can be viewed. So typically you will use some kind of a tool either on the web or on the console like this. And they are very useful in order if you have a large number of changes, you can do a bunch of things. And these tools will typically also have options that you can do commands, various things. Depending on the tool, there are a variety of tools. So there are some questions. Let me answer them first. Can we discard any revision completely? The point is you don't want to do that. The whole idea behind revisions is you don't want to destroy a revision. Keep it. What do you lose? Okay. So if you don't want a revision, don't use it. But the point is you want to keep track. So you want to know, oh, that time I did this. And I trust me, I have used revision control for many, many years. I don't know if I have any time when I have wanted to destroy a revision completely. Unless it's a public repository and you put some code that you don't want, even there, once you've made it public, it becomes very difficult to remove it completely because somebody else may be referring to your change. And if you remove it, their reference is gone. So it's a bad idea to remove anything. There are some things that you can do to cheat, to maybe edit it, but it's, I'm not going to teach it because it's simply too advanced. But the idea is you are not supposed to be removing any revisions. The whole point of a revision control system is that you keep all of the revisions. Okay, the next question is, once a file has been removed, it cannot be retrieved using HG revert. Yes, it cannot be, once a file has been removed and committed, remember, if you have committed it, you can only go back in time and re-add the file, right? If you removed it instantaneously, so if I say, now it will do, now it is recovered. So if you have changed, made it a commit, then you have to go back, get the previous version, which you know how to do. Go to update, minus update to that revision, grab the file, save it somewhere else and could put it back. You can do that. That's not a problem at all. You can re-add the file back in. Next question is how to change the editor option. Typically what I do is I set the environment variable editor. So if I set it to Vim, export editor equals Emacs, say. It will use Emacs for your editing. So if you want, I will repeat all the commands we have done so far. So what is the first command we encountered? Init. The second command we encountered was, what is the second command? Status. Thank you. Third command. Help. Very good. Then HG add files HG commit minus U Notice that if you specify specific files, only those will be committed. If you don't specify anything, everything will be committed. Next command, hg revert, okay, log, any options? One option that we looked at was minus L number, okay. Then next one, so somebody has asked me a question, hg log specific file, specify the file. And if you have questions like those, you should always consult help. Hg help log will tell you what and all log can do. Obviously, I can't cover every single thing. So if you have doubts of that nature, I mean, how do I do this, how do I do that, it's a good idea to just check with the help documentation, okay. Then next, what did we do? Hg revert, right? This you could say minus minus all, dangerous, or files. Then what did we do? Hg diff, very important, minus r, then hg update revision number, and then hg move or rename, what's that? Then we said hg view or install apt-get install hg view, okay. Different tools are there. There is something I used to use called olive or olive gtk. There are a bunch of tools, each will have its own advantages and disadvantages. Okay, so you have the tool you pick for visualization and all that is kind of out of scope, but just understand that it's convenient sometimes to be able to view, very convenient. So if you have a large project, you have a lot of changes, it's very convenient to say, oh, this is what it is. However, remember that the power of the whole thing is there in your command line. The command line, you can do everything from the command line. You don't have to really use a UI, and it's always useful to know the command lines, to know what are the options. So you can see that there are lots of options, but it's not too many. Bulk of the time you'll spend with, okay, init is done only once. So you hardly spend time with init. You spend time with status a lot, help a lot, easy. Log is very often used. Then there is commit, which is very often used. Add, reasonable. Every time you add a new file. Similarly, MV and RM are used whenever you change. Update depends on your needs. I have not used update too much personally, because I keep moving ahead rather than going in the back. If I need anything in the past, I can always find out the diff and then figure out what is wrong. So typically, you are using two or three commands. You are committing, adding. And that's bulk of the time you're only doing those operations. Okay. So it's not very difficult. It doesn't add a lot of overhead. Second question: why is the error waiting for lock on working directory coming? Well, I don't know. It looks like you've made a mistake in one of your previous hg commands has not completed, and your hg is basically locked up. I would suggest you wipe out the directory. Maybe there's some hung job or something you have. Look at the processes. I don't know how you managed to get into that state. It could be that you tried to commit, it broke, something didn't work and its edge is in one funny state. I have never run into this issue. How many commits can be submitted simultaneously? Next question. There is no notion of commits can be submitted simultaneously. Every commit is atomic, as I said. A commit is an atomic set of changes. So there is no committed continuously, how many at one time, there is one commit. After pressing commit, all my HG commands are showing parse errors. Okay. So that means it's likely that your HG RC is wrong. So I will simply cat my, and please use HG RC. That is how your HG RC should look. I have catted it. Make sure it is correctly formatted. If not, you will get parse errors. On what topics will we have multiple choice questions? I am surprised you are asking me these questions. On every topic under the sun we can think of, we will ask you questions. I will make sure we ask you questions that have not been taught in class. Yes, we will ask you questions mostly. I think it makes sense for us to ask questions about what we have covered today. RECC has asked me a question, give example of using plus symbol using HG diff. I don't understand. When you look at HG diff, it prints a plus symbol for every, so let me show you. HG diff minus R. Okay, so let's look at, I have now done HG diff minus R 0 to 2 hello.sh. What this is showing me is the difference between version 2 to the original version of hello.sh. Minus signs indicate lines that are removed. Plus signs indicate lines that have been added. Okay. So the next question is how memory management is done with HG. You mean to say the hard disk management? If you are saying hard disk management, every file is typical, different version control systems have different strategies. What they typically do is they store the differences. They don't store the entire files except for binary files. In the case of a binary files, very often it's difficult to make a meaningful diff, and therefore they'll store the entire file. Otherwise they will store just the differences, only the differences. So it's actually fairly optimal. And if you look at large projects, say the size of the kernel, it is actually very efficient. The entire kernel repository can be downloaded by anyone, and it's not that inefficient. So it's actually, they spend a lot of effort making it efficient. So you don't have to worry about memory management because disk space is almost trivially cheap today. So you shouldn't be worried about the memory that way. HG commit is waiting on lock on working directory. I would suggest if you are running into that problem, check your processes, make sure there is some commit command that has not failed in the past, and make sure that's been fixed. If not, create another revision control directory and start afresh. Next question is, any other version control mechanism in which is graphical? There are plenty. There's Tortoise HG, there's Olive GTK. There are plenty, and Google will give you plenty of hits on that. Revert will only give you the updated permissions that were checked into version control. Everything that was done in the last check-in is available, and that will be restored. The next question is, if one user changes file permissions, if we take difference in next version, it won't show the changes in file permission. User changes file permissions. File permissions are also logged. So if you change permission, it's going to version that information as well. If I remember correctly, it does store the permission information as well. So what is the, there is no, doesn't seem to be any issue with there. Well, it won't show you, when you do a diff, it cannot show you the diff in the permission, but it's there in the repository. So when you get it back, it will tell you. And collaborative work, this is never an issue really with collaborative work, with being file permissions are the least of your problems in collaborative work. Okay, so let me interact. Don Bosco College, Guwahati.
First error, it is not being removed after trying your suggestion. Get SRGC.
Correct. So the log message is not going to show you permissions. The log message is only going to show you the change log that was made. There is other information that is necessary that may be available that the log may not show you. But the information is there in the HG repository. Okay. So don't worry about the permission changes that were made to a file are not of relevance. Typically, when you're doing version control, the idea is you want to keep track of the changes to the files. The contents of the files, the permissions are really secondary. In my life, I don't think I've ever had to worry about the permissions of a file. I'm telling you honestly, I've been using version control for the last 10 years. There's definitely a case for it. I'm not denying it, but it is not primary. And the log file is not going to tell you permission changes. It's not necessarily even going to sometimes tell you the details about what has changed. Typically, a graphical tool or something like that will tell you more information. But log by default doesn't tell you every single detail is not going to tell you. Yes, so the HG is a content manager. It definitely is a content manager. In fact, content is the most important. You're getting a parse error. So I think you have not typed it properly in that case. Typing cat tilde HGRC, HRGC is not going to help you. I am just catting my version. You have to edit it and make it look like my version. Cat, I am just showing you what my file looks like, and please don't use my username. Change your username to your whatever your name is and your email address. Typing cat.hg or not HRGC, it's HGRC is only going to show you the listing of that file. Cat is not a HG command. Edit that file, change it to reflect something similar to this. See, this lock on working directory, again, you have basically, there's some command you have run. So let me try to make that same mistake. Yeah, what I did was I made a commit and I control Z from my editor, which means the commit, it's trying to commit, you have not finished editing, so it's locked up. Okay, so you control C or HG update, you foreground whatever process you are having, finish that, and now you do HG update, it will work. So basically you are having some commit that is uncommitted because you made a mistake. If you fix that, it will work. If not, throw away the directory you are working on and do it afresh on some other directory. Okay, make fresh files and do whatever you want. In the afternoon, we'll maybe go through an exercise of creating content, removing files, etc. So KJSM, other than username, which information, please read the manual. Please search on Google, there's plenty of information available on all of these details. What and all you can add, there are many things you can add. There's authentication, there are aliases, there's a bunch of things that you can add. There are specific project related data you can add in HGRC. So please refer to the help and the documentation. I think you can say HG help config and it should tell you a lot more information. So one question someone has asked, I think TINJRU has asked, please explain the first three lines we getting after executing HG diff. So if you look at the shell, HG diff minus R0:2, I'll pipe it to less so we can see it clearly. Okay, let's look at hello. So by the way, diff is a general Unix command. It's a standalone command also. I mean, HG diff is presenting you a diff, but diff itself is a command that is available on Unix. So the first three lines, if you want an explanation, the minus minus is telling you what line was there in the original file. The plus 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 is basically saying any line you see with a plus here refers to the subsequent version. Okay. So for example, if I did, I think this may work. Now it's gone the reverse. Now it's saying A is minus minus minus, which is the 12 o'clock version. B is 11 o'clock version, because I swapped the two version numbers. Okay, so it, the order matters. So 0 to 12 means what is there in 2, 0 colon 2 means what was there in 2 is now compared with what is with what was there in 0. What is there in 2 is compared with what was there in 0. So what I'm this is saying is B is 12 o'clock, A is 11 o'clock file, which is that revision, 0 revision. These were the lines that were present in the first. These are the lines that are currently present now. And these three lines are not there. The rest of the lines are there. This third line is a special magic diff line, which gives you which gives diff context information. It's saying that it's roughly around the first line. After the first line, these kind of changes are arising. Okay. So the diff file is simply it's a well known format. You can also man diff itself. There's information about what diff does in general outside the scope of HG. So diff is, please note that HG is also giving you a diff. So it's a general file difference structure that is used. Not a structure, a command that is used to generate these diffs. The good thing about diffs is you can use a diff to what is called patch a file. So given a diff, I can apply the diff to a file in order to bring it to the new version, because it has essentially recorded all the changes. Remove these lines, add this line. Okay, so one more question is, if another user in the group changes the file, how that changes are reflected in the log? So we will be talking about collaborating with Mercurial in the subsequent session, this session. So I will answer this question later on. But for now, what we will do is, I will give you a little exercise. I want you to do the following. I will put it in comments here. Create a project directory. Number two, initialize HG repository. Create a simple hello Okay. It's a little complicated. The last few steps are, you have to think a little bit. Don't just blindly do it. The first few parts are easy. The last two steps will require you to think a little bit. Okay. So I will give you about 10 minutes. You please do this. If you have questions, you please send a message on chat and I will answer. So I will repeat the question, create a project directory, then inside that project directory, initialize a HG repository, create a simple hello world shell script, do whatever you want inside, just echo hello world will work, anything you want, check that in, create another script, call it any name you want, check that also in, examine the logs. You should at least have two commits. Then remove hello.sh, check the removal. Remove money, you don't obviously, you shouldn't do rm. Use hg to remove it, check it in, get back version 2, copy the file hello.sh back into the repository. And these steps, I'm not telling you the answer. You have to think about it and do it based on whatever I've taught you. And finally, check back the new obtained version into the repository. Okay, I'll give you a hint. For number 10 and 11, you have to update, and you have to update carefully. Remember, you have to add the new hello.sh to the latest version. So please finish this assignment and then we will ask questions. I will answer questions. I'll give you 10 minutes. At 2:30 sharp, I will work through the solution. And if you have doubts, I'll answer them. Or I'll answer some basic doubts and then I'll show you the solution. So I hope most of you were able to execute the tasks. Should I show the actual workflow? Okay, some of you are keep getting this parse error. Please, if you are getting parse errors, make sure that you are. That your username looks like this. You have to say username space equals no quotation marks. And you have to give the email address there. So let's see if I can make a mistake here and show you. I've made it this. It works. So even if you just give your username like that, it should work. There should be a new line at that. So if you have not done it properly, the option is you say hg hg add touch. If you are getting that parse, test.sh hg ci minus u. If you are lazy to create that file, that also works. Okay? So if you are getting into these silly errors and getting stuck, use the minus u flag to pass in the argument, like what we did first. Okay, make sure don't make mistakes with. Oh, sorry. Someone is asking what is CI. CI is an alias for commit. I'm sorry. HG help commit. Aliases is CI. Okay. So CI is the same as commit. I have become used to typing CI, so I'm sorry. It just comes naturally. Okay. So let me solve your exercise. Okay, so I first create a directory, test, cd test, hg init, then then I do hg add hello.sh, then hg commit minus m hello.sh. So I'm just being lazy. You should actually type a proper log message. You don't need to pass the minus m. It'll open an editor and you can type and save and quit in that editor. Then what is the next command? Check in another shell script. So vim test.sh. Okay, so now I run set test.sh. It works. I'm happy. HG status. I have to add it, hg add test.sh, then hg status, it's added, so then hg commit, then hg log. I have two commits, okay, which is what I was asked to do. Then step number 9, remove hello.sh, 8 and 9, hg rm hello.sh, hg commit, so step number 9 is done. Now I need to extract the hello.sh from version 2 and copy it back. Version 2, no, version 1. I meant the second version, which is actually version 1. Now I do hg update hg update 1 to give me the second version. That gives me hello.sh. So I copy hello.sh to hg. Now I need to update to the latest version. I don't have hello, so I do cp now it's a new file, so I do hg add hello.sh, hg check in. So we're done. So it just takes a minute, and I'm able to revert. I'm going to go back, recover a file that I deleted accidentally or whatever, and get it back from the dead. So let us now look at one simple thing: hg log hello.sh. So the only real version of this file is revision 0. Let me make a change. Notice that HG is smart enough to realize that your hello.sh that you added back after you delete it has not shown up in another revision. Why? Because HG knows that the original hello.sh and the one you added in version 3 are identical. So it doesn't really care. It doesn't have to make a store of that. Okay? However, if I check back version 3, I will get back the file. And notice that it still remembers that it was the original hello.sh, and it shows you the log for that as 0, even though it is a fresh file that I apparently added. Does that make sense? So HG is kind of smart. It knows about the file, it knows about the history, and when you add something back with the same name, it knows what minimal set of change sets it needs to remember to generate that file. Therefore, it's a smart system. It's not a stupid system. Therefore, it's a good idea to rely on using the system effectively and not worry too much about, is it doing it correctly? Is it not doing correctly? You don't have to worry about it. Okay? So with that, we have done a basic introduction to HG and using HG. And typically, this much is enough if you want to get started using Mercurial. And for many of us, we don't have to collaborate. There are many things that you do. You may write a document, may write a tech file, you may be maintaining some personal documentation, you may be maintaining some HTML pages, your website, your source code, all of which are personal. They are not relevant to you, relevant to anybody else. So there's no question of saving the content to anybody else or sharing the content with anybody else and interacting. In such a case, it really makes sense to be able to be doing things on your own machine, and which HG makes it very easy to do. So if you have on your computer HG installed, you can use version control. You don't have to care about collaborating with somebody else, and you get all of the power of a distributed version control. So before we move into collaboration, I want to discuss one very simple fact about HG repositories. Notice that this test folder contains our HG repository. This test folder technically can actually be copied directly. So if you tar up this test folder and give it to a friend, they will have all of the contents of your files along with all of the history. That is the point of a repository. A repository means that it contains not just the working directory, which is all the files, hello.sh, etc. It also contains the history of all of those files. So they can do everything that you have been able to do up to now in that directory. The reason this is possible is because of the .hg directory.